Right, hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Empyrion Galactic Survival. My name is Sislak. Today's mission, if we choose to accept it, is to just do some mining. I've already hit up a iron mine, iron asteroid, which is back there, and further beyond it I hit a... cobalt asteroid. I want to get as much ice as I can. I'm now up to 8 drill lasers, and I've switched out the on the top of the drill lasers on the left hand side you've got the positron beam cannon, and on the right used to be a mining turret. Can't remember what it's called. Oh well. Used to be one of them for mining. I've now switched it out to the multi-tool turret, so that I can salvage whenever I want to salvage, rather than keep having to switch them back and forth. But yes, after I hit up this ice asteroid, and then I can finally get some warp containers and then make some better fuel for this ship, I will then go straight for the copper asteroid and destroy that, and I'll see what's going on over there as well. There's meant to be 3 ice asteroids in this sector, and this will be gone in a matter of a minute or so, because just look at that. I used to have just one of these, now I've got 8. I need one more. I need one more advanced. Right, sorry about that. My mic cut out a sec. I need one more advanced upgrade kit in order to make another mining laser, drill laser. As soon as I've done that, I've completed the set, but I do need 2 more advanced upgrade kits, one for the drill laser and one for the long range scanner. As soon as that is complete, I can then scan up to, I think it's 25,000 meters, or it may be 20,000, rather than the standard 8,000 on the standard detector. But the only difference between the long range and the standard detector is the long range scanner, the pings go away pretty quick, so you have to keep pinging, and you'll see what I mean when I eventually get one. But yeah, the standard one stays around for, I've never really counted, but I'd say about 30 seconds roughly, give or take 5 seconds. But yeah, the other one is so longer range, the quicker the shutdown time on it. Weird. But yeah, so without further ado, let's finish off this ice asteroid. At the moment, all of my constructors are busy working on what I've mined so far. So I've got 2 advanced constructors and 2 small constructors. All of them are working on, everything that I've done. See if we can get the last little drops of ice. And there's another little piece there. Oh, and just to let everyone know, I am back in the Alpha sectors, the Alpha system. So I've come back home, basically, to the original system where I came from. But with this server, if you've never been on Where Am I server, once you come off of Haven, Takodana, Haven, Akua, or Talador, I believe it is, Once you come off of any of those three, you cannot warp back to them. So if you've come out to, say, Alpha 7 that I'm on now, you will not be able to walk back to Haven. There's no locking target. It's a feature that's been disabled on this server, mainly because it's to help the newbie players, so the ones that are trying to get off the planet, it's to help them get all the resources, basically. So if you hunker down on the planet, I believe there's a 7-day grace, 7-day grace, roughly. So you have to get off the planet within 7 days, which is quite easy, because this server, if you join a Discord, there is a code at which you can gain access to a locker, which has a lot of resources in it, enough resources to get you your first CV vessel. Yeah, your first CV, so you can get off planet and venture out to the other alpha planets, or even venture out to the galaxy. Right. Let's see. So we've got on my radar, I'm at the ice asteroid. I've got a copper asteroid that I've found. I'll go up here. No, I'll go to the copper asteroid because I've got copper waiting to be turned into ingots, but I've only got 4 copper ores at the moment. Need 5 if you didn't know. But what I will do is, both of my advanced are going after the cobalt ice chunks. What I'm gonna do, warp containers, yeah. So I'm going to mass produce some water containers, so then I can get the mass produce water containers, so I can get everything else that I need. But for now, I'm just going to ping past these. I think there may be a mining foreman up there, possibility, but I'm going to go to this copper asteroid, mine it out, so I've got some resources for my constructors to work on. I'm fine for Promethean at the moment. I'm keeping the 2,000 odd Promethean. Oh, there's another heat signature back there. What is that? You are unknown. So let's just put a waypoint to unknown so it doesn't disappear. Yeah, I've got 2,000 Promethean pellets at the moment, but I am going to use them eventually, because I need to convert them into the fuel cells. What are they called? The Promethean hydrocells, because they can do so much more. Right, copper asteroid 2.6 ahead. So that's 2.6 kilometers. I used to do it in yards, but I can't. I can do yards. I like Imperial instead of the metric system, but I started this game on the metric system, so I got too used to it, and then I couldn't judge the distances. Couldn't judge the distances correctly when I was firing weapons or lasers, so I've stayed with the metric system. What I do need to find is some silicon. I know I can change the crushed stone in my mining box into silicon. It just takes a lot of time. But I do need to find some silicon rock, a silicon asteroid, so that I can actually get some silicon. I also need to find some safium. I think I need about 21,000 silicon ore. No, ingots. Because I am trying to bring in a massive size 15 space station, which happens to be another build of Spange build, yep. It's the Frontier Station, which, if you don't know about Frontier Station, it was a size 29. And today I spent probably about 4 hours just trying to dwindle it down to size 15. So yeah, I've spent a lot of time on this game already today, but it just so happens that I needed a station. I've got the outpost that is in Polaris space, but I do also want to get the Frontier Station and put that somewhere else, so then that way I've got... Ooh, what are they? Right, sorry, got distracted. Let's go out here, shall we? I don't know what the light green is. Where's that? Polaris? Attenberg? Those are destroyed vessels. Where's Polaris Attenberg? Oh, you're down there. Attenberg. You're a heat signature of Polaris. You must be a drone. I have totally forgotten what I was saying about, apart from Frontier Station. Words. Yeah, the Frontier Station is going to be located somewhere in between. I think I'm going to put it in colonist space, to be honest. Because I've got some bounties that I need to turn into colonists, but it's just a case of finding a colonist bounty station and putting it there. Yeah, I am not going near that ship. That derelict ship? Oh, it's such a... Right, flyby. I'm going to do a flyby on it, then I'm going to go for that silicon. Let's see if this legacy ship has some guns on it. If it does... Well, it's on, so it's got to have some guns. Hopefully my weapons open fire on it, destroy its generators. One faction you do not want to mess with is Legacy or the Krill. I've been to the Krill home sector and it was a nightmare. Absolute nightmare. Luckily at the time I was honoured with the Krill, but they are attack on sight. Right. We're just within range. Right. You're firing. You're the only one that's firing. Oh, we're getting more fire. Let's see, what are my guns firing on? Generators. So the generator's located in about the center. So let's see if we can move around for it. Oh, it's this ship. Firing about there. Right, okay, go on in, boys. Open fire. Minigun turrets, you need to stop. Miniguns. Do not fire on bases, miniguns. Bases. Capital vessels, no. Miniguns, do 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 do. I think one of the miniguns is still no, they've all stopped. Don't want to get too close because I don't know if this thing's got. There goes one. Yeah, I think this is a POI. I don't think this is going to work. Those blocks look indestructible to me. Yep. Okay, indestructible blocks. Yo, my boys, turn your targeting systems off. There you go. And there's another heat sink to my right. Heat sig. Sink. I keep saying sink. Right, so I need to do this quick because time's about the essence. I need to do the silicon asteroid, check out the other heat signature, and obviously there's another heat signature over there, another 31k away. Wow. Let's turn that on and let's see how my mining stuff is doing. You got 5,000, yeah, we're fine. We're fine. Nothing to worry about. Right. Let's go and take this on. Because obviously I am in love with this ship now, I don't even need to worry about where I hit this asteroid. I could just burrow my way through it. And let's see, there's more up here. Need all the silicon. Give me all your silicon. Silicons are plenty. Right, I am gone from that. Can never tell what's silicon and what's not on this rock, but I think this is all silicon. Oh, now I can see it. It's a little hard to distinguish. Other ores like iron, safium, sascosium, probably bodged that, and restrum, those are the easy ones to tell what colour they are compared to the asteroid. But yeah, there are a few that are very similar in colour, especially magnesium and titanium. And to this asteroid, silicon. But yeah, we're getting some silicon now. Brilliant. Love it. Need as much silicon as we can possibly get. I could take down this asteroid, but time's of the essence. And it's something we simply do not have a lot of. Right. 10 kilometers in that direction, and I'm gonna have to end that episode there. So I will figure out what these other heat signatures are, and next time we'll probably be either just about setting up our new base, or we will be in colonist space at a bounty hunter's sector, so that we can turn in these bounties and get some rewards from it. Right then, thank you so much for watching. I know it's just been mining, but it's what I do. I am a miner, and I love doing it. Right. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.